All right, welcome back. It's Tuesday morning at 8:20. Doing a quick intro today because I want to get started on events. I'm still going to film the swing instant pirouettes and all the stuff I do on P-bars before I go to the events. I'm just going to speed it up so that way we can get into the events quicker today. Filming it just so I can hold myself accountable because today is one of those days where I really don't want to do them. So let's get to it. Try and save my hands the best I can. I'm just gonna go for double layout on this one. The goal on this one, aside from the nice tight tap on the backside and keeping my head up when I swing through the bottom, is as I come over on the first layout, and I usually do this, I'm gonna try and bring my head in and just spot the pit before I do the second flip. That one did not work. Got a little spooked on the last one because I don't usually open my eyes when I flip. To try and help me open at the right time, I think after I release the bar, I'm obviously gonna try and bring my head in, but I don't wanna keep them open the whole time. So as I bring my hands down to my legs, that's when I'm gonna try and open and just stay looking down as I go through the second flip. Okay, this is kind of annoying. Doesn't help that I've done it wrong for so long where I just kick and throw my head out and close my eyes. Guess I'll give it another shot. It might be freaky, but I think I might try and pick my head up through the bottom, and as I kick and I try and turn over and look for the pit, I might try and keep my eyes open the whole time. So that way, as I'm turning over this way, if my head is here and I can spot it kind of early, it might be a little more natural to kind of almost keep my head fixed looking down and then let my body catch up. Because I think if I can feel that and I feel and I hit this spot right here and I can spot it for a second, I feel comfortable doing the half in, half out technique. Okay, I know it looks like shit right now, but that one, my head was out the whole time, which isn't necessarily a good thing, but my eyes were open. I just gotta think, as soon as I release, as long as I kick back to the bar, I pick my head up to spot the pit and then bring it down. I gotta give myself a chance to spot the pit so it doesn't look like I'm just constantly rotating. What I mean by that is, like, my POV, once I spot up there before I let go, it looks like all I see is ceiling, wall, pit, wall, ceiling, wall, pit, wall, land. And there's no one point where I bring my head in and just stop for a second, even though my body's rotating. All right, attempt number four is just such a uncomfortable feeling for me. As soon as I let go and the toes are coming back to the bar, chin to chest, and that's it. Chin to chest and just try and look at the pit as long as I can. I just don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I don't know why I can't bring my head in as I turn over, or just at least stop and look at the pit. I think the problem is I don't know exactly when to bring my head in to be able to spot the pit. Because in theory, as I bring my head down to spot the pit, that's when I can drop my one shoulder to do a twist. It just happens so fast. Fuck. We'll be right back. Okay, not at all how I've been doing my double layouts. Grips feel a little slippery, bar feels a little slippery, but I was mainly just focused on trying to do the twist. The same way I had to break the ice, doing a double tuck, then a double lay. I just needed to do that one to kind of get the confidence back a little bit and get the feeling.
All right, I think I got two more in me because the wrists and hands are hurting a little bit. Considering that was my first time doing the full in a couple years, it actually wasn't as bad as I thought. And I tapped super early and still kind of buried my head. So maybe it won't be as bad as I thought if I can't spot the pit. Felt like much better rotation off the bar, and I know I still buried my head. God, dismounts make my wrist get really tender really quickly. And I think it's just because I'm a big guy cranking on the bar and there's a lot of force pushing on my wrist. If I kind of like it, I might just call it there because it felt pretty good and I don't want to rip because I can always come back to these on Thursday. I know I made the change to make the tap go a little bit later, but I don't think I really held the kick through the bottom. My head was still kind of here. So as soon as I kicked, I just closed and kind of threw my head out. I don't know how many times I need to say it. You guys know I'm trying to keep my head up. I'm just hoping that if I say it enough, it's just gonna be stuck in my brain and hopefully soon it'll become more normal to just open in the bottom and just look up. Cause that's the way I wanna go. I don't wanna look forward cause then I'm gonna go that way and it's just gonna be all whippy. Wrists are on fire, but I put some vitamin E underneath my tape. So hopefully it slides and you know the tape and the sweat doesn't make my skin peel off. Yeah, last one, best one. I'm gonna scare myself, make a change. I'm gonna try and slow down just a hair to help me feel more comfortable tapping later and picking my head up. I don't even care if it didn't look that different. I know for a fact that as I tapped to the bottom, I saw the ceiling. Might have only been for a brief second before I started to just kick and closing my shoulders instead of getting my feet up first, but it's another big step for me. Like I mentioned before with dismounts and tocaches, really just anything with high bar other than in bars, there was never a time throughout my entire career where I'd be able to do a release or a dismount and not be just worried about doing the skill. There might have been like a handful of days here and there where it was just a good day and I was kind of in the rhythm or in the zone to keep trying the same skill and making small changes, but there was always that thought in the back of my head, like, oh, what if something goes wrong? What if you slip? What if you hit the bar? Because I was always worried that if something like that did happen, I wouldn't be able to get back up on the bar and try again. So I think I'd always kind of like play it safe just on the off chance that something did go wrong and I wouldn't be able to do it again, or I wouldn't be able to make myself do it again. Even though I did want to be able to do that turnover, spot the pit and half-half, because I think that would have been the difference between me doing the same half-half I've done before and potentially feeling comfortable with trying a double-double. I will still take this because I know that if I ever want to play with triples again, which I will, it's the same concept where I need to pick the head up to the bottom, get the feet up fast, and then launch upwards before I start trying to bring my knees in to rotate. It's a problem for another day. Fingers crossed I can take these grips off and I see my wrists are still in one piece. Let's go to floor. Alright, tentative plan. Do a few back double fulls, maybe some 2.5 punch timers without the punch just because I'm still worried about the dead spot. And the last couple days I've been doing them on rod floor. I've been dropping the shoulder, so I want to make sure that doesn't mess with me on real floor. Assuming those feel good, knees, ankles, Achilles feel good, I might do a couple triples to a sting mat. And then after that, it'll just be timers for my forward connection passes. I think that should be a nice way to ease back into doing real floor after, I guess 3 weeks now-ish since I hit that dead spot. So let's get to it. Also, this is a good change. I arguably did a couple more turns on high bar than I should have because my wrist started hurting, I don't know, probably honestly 4 or 5 turns before I actually finished. And usually when I hit that point, I'll rip in the next 1, 2, maybe 3. And my wrists are very tender right now, but there's no blisters. So unless there's some hidden that I can't see right now because there's chalk,
is a good sign. Maybe my wrists are getting a little tougher. Moving on to the back 2.5s. Still going to be taking the same amount of steps that I usually do for connection pass, but I think I'm going to give it a shot dropping that left arm a little early in order to make it lower and still have the same amount of time to prep. And we'll just see where we get. I don't think it's going to mess with me too much. Too much height, I think. Well, maybe not too much height, because it does feel a little lower than normal, but it's not getting enough rotation. I think this is where, when I was on rod floor and I was saying, as hard as I'm dropping the left arm to start the twist early, this arm needs to go kind of over my head to get the rotation going. It's just harder on floor because the punch happens so much quicker. Feels a lot more goofy on here than rod floor. I'm gonna do like 2, maybe 3 more. It's the right idea, throwing the right arm over my head. I'm just not doing it enough, I don't think. Part of me is probably holding back because I don't want to do it too much and get kind of caught up in the twist or maybe get lost, I guess. Definitely felt like I got the twist going earlier, but I don't think it was because I actually dropped that left arm down. It felt like it more went like around the side, I guess, which is probably why when I broke out, even though I tried to square up, if I'm breaking out of the 2.5 and I'm supposed to finish facing this way, I don't think I gave myself enough time. So even though I tried to square up, the floor hit me a little early, and then I jumped a little off to the right. It might be hard to tell from that angle, but it did pull me off to the side a bit. Definitely felt lighter on my feet, like it was easier to punch for that front tuck, even though it happened really quickly. I think that might be the main thing to focus on if I'm actually trying to do something more than just a punch front tuck, is yes, get that 2.5 going a little early, but making sure it doesn't pull me off to the side. Even when I do my old technique, I guess, that would still sometimes be a problem where I cut the round off around the side and kind of set off to the side and it would pull me that way. But it's not bad though, it shows promise. Uno mas. All right, that one was much straighter, but I felt the 2.5 kind of go up a little bit first. I didn't really pull that left arm back. Don't need to overdo it today. It's still a work in progress. I'm gonna move on to triples. I'm gonna toss the sting mat in, so hopefully my ankle bones don't say hi to each other, and then we'll move on to the forward connections. Please pray for my ankles. Might be harder to tell from this angle, but I landed a little bit heavier on that right side, probably because I broke out a little late. The reason I broke out a little late was it didn't feel quite as high as the last one, even though the last one pulled back more. When I feel that kind of punch where it doesn't lift as quickly off the floor, it's better to play it safe and make sure that that twist gets all the way around and then open, which usually causes me to break out and kind of keep twisting, which puts the weight more on the right. If I can put the last two together where I feel it kind of have a quicker takeoff, a better change in direction with a fast twist, I'll be able to break out and land nice and square in theory. So again, hard to tell from this angle. It still did land a little heavy on the right, but I felt a quicker punch off the floor, which means that I did have a little bit more time to break out. That could have just been that when I did break out, instead of being really sharp and then pulling my arms around, I kind of, not half-assed it, but I was a little bit lazy going here and then kind of just waiting for the floor to hit me. If I'm twisting to the left and I kind of break out not fully or like really sharp as I come around, my body's still gonna keep twisting, which is gonna put more pressure on that right side. Minor details. All right, just to take care of my knees and make sure they are good to go for Thursday. Well, also to make sure that they're not feeling like absolute shit tomorrow morning so they can be good for Thursday. I'm just gonna do some lay punch front timers with a sting mat in, I don't know, let's say anywhere from 5 to 7, and then we'll move on. Feels like a nice tight punch. I'm sitting up a little too slow coming out of that layout. So even though it is responsive off the floor, it's just carrying forwards. As good as rod floor is to practice the technique of it, the timing is very different. So to be able to translate from rod floor directly to floor, not only is it tough and tricky, but it does take quite a bit of practice. Even though I'm comfortable going back and forth between the two, to be able to replicate the technique that I like over here on floor, it's very different. A decent change. I wasn't fully ready with my feet under me to get a really big snap, but I think I pulled my chest forward and my arms up almost at the perfect time. I think I'm gonna go to pommel first. Try and get that out of the way before I go and do my sport stuff on P-bars.
Oh, Don has most of them. I forgot what it is. Wait, what?
Controls or what?
That's what I would have said. Fortunately, I choked that first half attempt because I got cocky on the stock lead. I'm just trying to make it through one upgraded first half with both flops, and then all the focus is just going to be on scissors. So the scissor, I'm still trying my best, but it's not the main focus. It's mainly to just get through the flops, and then I will buckle down and focus on the details for scissors. Now I am traveling off that Russian, just completely in a pike, because I don't want to overdo leaning too far to the right. So I guess subconsciously that means close up and circle in an L sit. Can't do that. Well, this is backwards. Usually E-flop's not a problem. Usually it's the Russian. Regardless, when I stepped up for the E-flop, I didn't fully like push down with my left arm, and I scooped my toes, which just threw everything off. I need to make sure that when I actually do get a turn like that, when the Russian feels good, that I don't hold back and close up. If anything, I kind of go for it harder and even like with more confidence, I guess. Did not absolutely destroy myself. I'm just gonna try and do one Russian down to E Stockley and then be done before scissors. Oh, I fucking hate flops, man. This is fucking bullshit. Alright, even though that wasn't E Stockley, I technically did make both flops. Even though they both just felt like ass and it was very closed off. But the main focus for today was supposed to be scissors anyways. It wasn't supposed to take me that long to do one of each half. but we'll move on to scissors now. Alright, very obvious to tell from this angle, but because I'm turning too early, that's what's causing my right leg to bend. If I pick my left leg up faster while staying square and then initiate the turn after my right leg clears the horse, I think it'll be easier to keep my leg straight. Was a little bit better, and I think I stayed more square longer, but because it's taken me so long to get my left leg up, I think that's why I feel the need to kind of pull my butt back, which is why my right leg is bending. So as I'm staying square, I'm just gonna try and pick my left leg up earlier and faster. I hate this fucking skill. I've only got a couple more left in me. My wrists are actually okay, other than the there's a scab on the back of my wrist that the wrist sport keeps pushing on, and I feel like I'm gonna hit a certain point with this where there's only so much I can get done today. Just gotta keep working on them. See, that one actually felt better, but my knee was probably still bent. It was probably still a soft catch. Only objective for this one is just to keep my right leg straight in the front. Doesn't matter how early I turn, I should be able to keep it straight, right? Probably still bent. Closer, but still a slight leg bend. In order to keep my leg straight, it almost feels like I have to kind of swing my left leg up with my hips closed a little bit. And then once my right leg has cleared the handles with a straight leg, that's when I turn and drive my heels. I know I'm just rushing it. It's just, again, a bad habit that I've done for so long that has yet to be corrected.
Hi, welcome to Chili's.
You gotta
that just wasn't funny.
You gotta go a little higher pitch than that.
Hi, welcome to Chili's.
No, that's too high.
Damn it. All right, you know, I'll work on it.
Just get out of here.
It's more like nasally.
Hi, welcome to Chili's.
Hey, welcome to Chili's.
You know,
you're gonna sound like a
high-pitched
Jewish person.
Damn it, Ariel.
Okay, even though none of them were like really good, I guess, I have an idea in mind for the next time I do scissors. To a point where it's better from handstands, not swing. That was pretty good. Okay, Tuesday practice, finito. Had a pretty good day, if you couldn't tell. Really, the only thing that stands out in my mind that kind of bothered me about the day was how I wasn't as efficient as I would have liked to have been on pommels, and how I didn't really make as many changes on my scissors that I was hoping for. It wasn't necessarily like a really bad pommel day, it just could have been better, I guess. It was nice to be able to get back on floor and do quite a bit of volume without having to worry about my knees. And even now, like, when the soreness is settling in for the rest of my body, I'm not really feeling anything in my knees, which is a very good sign. And then P-Bar's just working on the support stuff still. Another day where I felt like I'm making a little bit more progress, getting more comfortable, making the necessary changes to be more consistent. So that is a big step. I was hoping to have more time to play with stutzes a little bit with the new timing and technique, but
wasn't meant to be today, which is fine. I think it'll be good in the future to start with the DOMs and maybe DOM and a quarters. And when I find a day where I feel like that stuff is like really clicking right from the start, that would be a better opportunity to then explore making the proper changes with stuts. Because to be perfectly honest, I'm not sure how it's going to feel doing a stuts, waiting that long to start pushing off the P-bars and all that kind of stuff. But might be Thursday, might be next week, I'm not sure, but it will be soon. For word of the day, if you made it this far, comment twisting, because I twisted my hybrid dismount today. Woo! Got a nice day off tomorrow where I'll rest and recover and then hit it hard again on Thursday with all four events. Hope you enjoyed watching my Tuesday morning training, and I will catch you guys on Thursday.